Hi friends, I am your Appian sir. It is easy to remain in touch with me if you follow my Facebook page Atma Prakash sir. Dear friends, if you are appearing any competitive examination, then having knowledge of subject-verb agreement is highly essential. Subject-verb agreement follows one fundamental rule. The rule is, in an English sentence, verbs must agree with its subject in number and person. In this video, we will learn about number and person of his subject. Do you know anything about number and person? It is very simple. A subject may be singular or may be plural. The idea of singular or plural refers to the number of a subject. If you want to know more about subjects, then watch my previous video with the title Intro to Subject-Verb Agreement. Now let us take two sentences to understand the number of a subject. The first sentence is, a cow is grazing in the field. And the second sentence is, cows are grazing in the field. In the first sentence, we are talking of one cow. Here the subject, a cow, is a singular subject. But in the second sentence, the subject, cows, is a plural subject. When a subject denotes one object or thing of its kind, it is singular, and when it denotes more than one things or objects of the same kind, it becomes plural. For example, boy is the singular form, but boys is the plural form. Similarly, tree, trees, child, children, dog, dogs, man, men, box, boxes, are the singular and plural forms of respective nouns. The bottom line is, when we consider the number of a subject, we determine whether the subject is singular or plural. This concept of number plays a vital role in subject-verb agreement. Let us take some example. We say, the dog is growling. But when the subject becomes plural, we say, the dogs are growling. In the first sentence, we use singular verb is, but in the second sentence, we used are, because in the second sentence, the subject is plural. Now, I will give some idea about person. There are three ways to refer a person. They are the first person, second person, and third person. I and we, perspective of a person, is the first person. When the subject refers to itself, the subject is first person. In the sentence, I love dancing, the subject is I, and the subject I refers to itself. Hence, in this sentence, the subject is the first person. You perspective is the second person. And all the rest, which is neither I, nor we, nor you, is the third person. Now I give you some example sentences. Kavita is a nice girl. In this sentence, neither I am Kavita, nor you are Kavita. So it is neither first person, nor second person. It is third person, as Kavita refers to a single girl or woman. Kavita will be third person and singular number. As Kavita refers to a single girl or woman, Kavita will be third person and singular number. In the sentence, you are a nice boy, you is not the first person. It is the second person. Similarly, in the sentence, I am a gentle person, the subject I refers to itself. Hence, the subject I in this sentence is the first person. I refers to a single person, hence it is first person but singular in number. The dog is barking. In this sentence, the dog is the third person. In the sentence, you are shouting, the subject you is the second person. In the given sentence, I do not like it, the subject I is first person, singular number. I am telling you a story about a farmer. Here, the subject I is the first person, you is the second person, and a farmer is the third person. It is a well-known rule that the verb in present indefinite takes s or es form if the subject is in the third person singular form. For example, I will say, the boy goes to school every day. In this sentence, the subject is the boy and it is third person and singular number. Hence, the verb go takes yes and becomes goes in the sentence. If we rewrite the sentence with the subject, the boys, instead of boy, making it plural, then the subject will be third person and plural. It is no more third person singular. As a result, the sentence will be, the boys go to school every day. Now let us discuss some questions. See dash three languages. The two options are given speak and speaks. The subject is see. It is third person and singular. Hence, speaks will be the right answer. Then come to the second question. Gina is a language professor. See dash French. The two options are teach and teaches. Which will be the right option? The answer, the right option will be the same as before. Teaches. Because Gina is a third person singular number. Similarly, take another example. I always dash the door at night. In this sentence, the subject is I. It is singular number, but it is first person. Hence, the verb will not take S or ES form. The two options are lock and locks. The right answer will be lock. Let us take one more example. The food in Sweden is very expensive. It does a lot to live there. The subject in the second sentence is it. It is not a first person, not a second person. It is a third person. Hence, the right answer will be costs, not cost. The right answer will be with the S form. So, costs is the right answer. Hope my learners now know about person and number in grammar. Thank you very much. Once again, we will meet on this topic in the next video.